Are you looking for a solar floodlight? I've got one right here that this company sent to me. I want to open it up and see what kind of floodlight they have in here. I want to see if it's the best solar floodlight, and we're going to do that in this review video right here. First of all, hi. Hi to all the new dads out there. This is Dad Reviews. This is where I give you my unedited, hopefully more authentic look at the products that I like, use, and have, and, well, companies send to me in the mail and sponsor this video. So if you're interested in that, you might want to consider clicking that subscribe button. So this company wanted me to check out their solar floodlight here, and this one's a little bit different from some of the other solar lights that I've done here on the channel, because this one actually has a solar panel that is not attached to the light. It's actually run down a cord, so you could actually install the solar panel, a good ways away from where the actual light is. This is the another box. We got a double box, double unboxing here. Let's see. Let's open up this one right here. And inside the packaging, we have that right there. Let's see what all we have in here. Okay, oh, cool. They sent you some mounts so you can stake it into the ground. This feels like all aluminum cast right here. Cast aluminum, I think. Those are some nice heavy-duty stakes right there. I really like these. And it's got the mount on top here for, I guess, either the light or the solar panel. Whoa! Comes with all your washers and everything that you need to get it staying onto there. That is super fantastic. I really, really like these stakes here, because I've seen other stakes in the past where it's like, you know, a plastic stake or whatever. And down here in Louisiana, we have really hard soil, so it's hard to get some of those plasticky stakes in there. This right here, I believe, is the solar light. From what I was reading online, it comes with two remotes, which is super cool. And it also has 60 LEDs on there. So let's go ahead and open this thing up right here. As you can see, this is the cord that you plug in for the solar power panel. So that's going to plug into the cord that's attached to the panel. And then it'll be able to charge through there. It says it has a 6,000 milliamp hour lithium ion battery in there. And like I said, it has 60 LEDs on the front there. So you're going to get a lot of light out of this thing. This is a IP67 waterproof. By the way, I'm going to link this thing up down in the description below. If you guys want to go and read other people's reviews about it, not just take my word for it. I'm just checking it out for the first time here and giving you guys everything that I know about it. But go and read some of those others' reviews, because some of the best information comes from those reviews. But from what I've read, this thing is all cast aluminum right here, and it's got that IP67 weather proofing, if you will, waterproof. So you can take it, it can take an outdoor beating if the weather gets nasty. Also, I read that it was really good in extreme heat or extreme cold conditions, so that's great as well if you live in the north or the lower in the south like we do. I'm noticing right here on it, looks like it has some kind of little light right there, or a sensor of some sort. I'm not too sure exactly what that is. So we're going to have to play around with that. May have to do a follow-up review of this thing right here. Let's see. We have, this looks like some mounting kits right there. Good hardware right there. Not too shabby there. Really making sure that you have everything that you need to get this thing installed correctly. Now, the last thing in the box here is the solar panel. Well, there's some instructions in here as well. Let's see. Let me go ahead and take a look at that super duper quick. Have a nice day, and a little dear friend, thank you very much for purchasing. These are all of the instructions. Oh, okay, I just noticed that too. Well, I guess we need to get this thing out before I can talk about that. This right here is the solar panel. They send it to you nice and bubble wrapped up, which is always good so that it doesn't get messed up. Wow, nice long cord on here. This is awesome, and it's got some kind of, I don't know how this works right here, but I know this is what makes the connection to the solar panel so that it can charge it. But look at how much cord you get right here. Good size solar panel here. I can't really tell. I don't really know how to describe how long. I mean, it's about, what, a foot and a half by a foot maybe, I guess. And it also has the bracket on here so that you can use either the stake. You can mount that right there, or you can mount it onto your wall or your house, your roof, or something like that as well. It says on, well, here, look, I'll just do this. The specs on this, I noticed that the maximum power on there is 6 watts, but if you guys want to pause the video, y'all can get all those specs right there to make sure it's what you need in a light. Now, the thing that I was kind of checking out first was the length of this cord, because this thing is super long. You could definitely get this, I would say, from the top of your roof, coming down a pole, or coming down off the side of your house if you wanted to put something kind of up high on an eave or something like that. You get a long cord here. This is great. And then I was also talking about how it's has that IP67. Y'all know how we review cords here on, check out the length of cords here on Dad Reviews. I'm 6 feet tall and I'm a square, so that right there is 6 feet. Plus another 6 feet, that's 12 right there. Plus another, that's about half right there. So another three, that's 12, 15 foot of wire right there. Now the thing that I was noticing about this is that the plugger inner right there is shoved down into this plastic part right here. So whenever you go to connect it, you are actually creating a weather seal tightness right there. It's super weather tight so that rain can't get into there. You can even see the ridges on the plug right there to be able for it to hold against this in place. Man. There we go. That's definitely snug, so that is not getting any water into there. Totally protected, very much like that. So actually right now we are connected, but I don't think that the lithium battery has any juice in there right now, so we're gonna have to do a follow-up review of this thing so that we can see how this thing performs. I'm very curious to know the lighting features and how bright this thing gets. Now, the other thing that I wanted to touch on was the remotes that you get two of them, which is cool, so you can have two of them around the house or wherever you want them. You can even like Velcro them to a wall or something like that, so you could easily set it or turn it on off or whatever. But you can set it for different modes. There's of course on and off, and then an auto mode. I'll link this thing up down in the description below, and y'all can go read a little bit more about exactly how the remote works. But from what I understood, there's different time lengths that you can do, 3 hour all the way to 8 hour, and it can do those certain times based on how bright or dim the solar panel is, because you can also change the brightness right here. You can set it to a certain percentage, or you can do it manually right there, which I thought was super cool, and just a great little remote so that you can control it a little bit easier than you can, you know, by having like a button on it or something like that. Although I would say that a button on here would be nice somewhere, although that probably would take away from some of the weather resistant stuff that this thing comes with. A nice mounting bracket on the back of the light here. Of course, you have your two holes there if you want to really get it into there, or if you want to stake it again, you can use the other stake, because remember, this came with two stakes. You have one for your panel and one for your light right here, which I think is super cool. I would love to know how you guys would use this kind of light at your house. Do you plan on using it like in your garden, or do you want it for more of a security light? How do you guys plan on using it? Let me know that down in the comments below. And like I said, if y'all want to check this thing out, read up a little bit more about it, go read some of those other reviews. I'm gonna link it up down in the description below. Y'all go and check that out and see what other people are saying about this to make sure that it is the best light out there for you, for your house. So if you guys are liking what we're doing here on Dad Reviews and you want to see more of our videos, make sure to click that subscribe button. I'm gonna put some more videos right there on the screen that I think you guys are gonna like. Y'all click one of those videos, I'll see y'all in those videos. Thank you, dads, for watching. That thumbs up is always appreciated. Share this on Facebook with somebody who's been looking into this, or someone you know who may own a home or something like that. I think that they might find this interesting. Thank you, dads, for watching, and Dad out.